So I just recorded a video and I'm like, wow, this video was super cool. I did some cool attacks and then it sounds like this. So I plugged my microphone in and we're back. We're gonna do an attack here. And you know, I'm still gonna try and do some cool attacks. And trust me, there's gonna be a unique army in this video somewhere. Right now, we're just gonna absolutely demolish this base though with this LT null strategy. And I know I've been gone for a little bit. I've been doing the tournament videos. We're back with live attacks for the foreseeable future. So, why don't we just go take out this base? All we gotta do is take out this Archer Tower and then we get the air bombs, roaster, and Mega Tesla, and then it's free. I mean, really, OA Fury built this base, and I don't even know how, because this base is actually one of the easiest bases in the meta right now. All you gotta do is take out the Archer Tower, and then you just win. It's easy as that. I mean, even if you guys did watch the tournament videos, which I know a lot of you guys didn't like, but I had to post them. Look, if I needed to post them, because I have to like get numbers on them so I can actually do tournaments in the future. So for all you guys who had to suffer through that, I'm sorry. Trust me, I didn't like having to post them that frequently either. I wasn't really necessarily happy with how much I had to post them. And I know you guys didn't enjoy it either, and I really do like to do things that you guys enjoy. So I am sorry for having to post those so much, but like, I had to. But anyway, if you watch the tournament, all that to say, this base somehow got failed against with the strategy I'm using now. So, Jopo, if you're watching this, this is how you do this. This is how you take down the base without getting a one star. So all you gotta do is then look, now we've taken down the air bombs, we've taken down the roaster, Battlecopter's gonna come through here, and then the ability will take out the lowered Archer Tower, Mega Tesla, I'm sorry, Air Expo, and the Lava Launcher and Archer Tower, and then look at this. Look, the Cannon Cart literally gets 3 out of the 4 biggest defenses in the game here. And then it's free. Easy as that. So, I mean, if you guys are having trouble against this base, just try this strategy out. It does take a little bit of skill with the Cannon Carts, but honestly, I'm gonna be real. It's probably one of the easiest approaches against this base. I mean, even though it does take some Cannon Cart knowledge, it really isn't that hard still. I mean, look, we have, even if you had messed up something, we have all of our baby dragons alive with the abilities here. I mean, it's one of the easiest approaches to do here. So I feel like this is a good way to start the second part of this video off, swagging our literal entire army against this base with the abilities. So now we gotta go to the second stage. I'm pretty sure I can destroy that too. And we're just gonna try and be finishing off with as many troops as possible. I mean, look at this, everything, you don't see this that often. Not that often. I did actually though get an attack where I had my entire army alive, all 8 troops, not even like one barbarian dead. We had the whole army alive. That was probably one of my pinnacles of my career here. But anyway, let's just go ahead. We're gonna try and swag at least 5 baby dragons here. All we're gonna do is barbarian, test for traps, no traps found. Now we go guard post units with the cannon carts, and then we should be able to take this out pretty easily. We're just gonna let these guys walk a little bit. There we go, boom. And then we should go to the gold mine, and then hopefully to the firecracker, then to the builder hall, and that should be really all I gotta do, because we're gonna get down 2 firecrackers here, and then we can take down the cannon. And now one thing I do wanna try this, I saw someone do this, and I have no clue how it works. I think you just pause them like that, and then they should take out all the zappies. Dude, that's so, so cool. I've never done that before. I saw C6 Shrimp do it, and I'm like, I gotta try that. And that does actually take him out so much quicker than the other away. Where you just kind of let them go for it. So really, really cool little trick there. Let's go see if I can still finish off the base now. I think Battle Machine from the corner is the best move here, because he should be able to clear out these buildings for the baby dragons to fly straight in at the firecrackers. And then we'll go ahead, take out the cannon and the elixir storage, and that's going to be pretty easy. And I mean, look, we have literally 5 baby dragons, all with the ability here left. If I failed this, I'll quit YouTube, I'll quit the builder base, I'll quit life if I fail this. I mean, honestly, I would never be able to forgive myself. So why don't we go use Battle Machine ability. We can use the cannon carts now to go take down this cannon. And then Battle Machine ability here, that should take down everything even quicker. And look at that, do we even need the baby dragons? Dude, we're gonna swag 5 baby dragons here. And this isn't even gonna be the thumbnail. This isn't even gonna be the thumbnail. I already know what the thumbnail is. I'm gonna make the thumbnail whatever cool army I end up doing. I haven't quite done it yet. I did do an attack where I was able to finish off a base with 5 Electrofire Wizards, 2 Cannon Carts, and some Barbarians. But anyway, we literally don't use 5 baby dragons here. They all have their ability. That's a cool one to start the video off on, I guess. We're up against the same guy here. It looks like he changed bases, which honestly, I would have too after that. But how do we do this one now? We got to go with something cool at some point here. I mean, Electrofire Wizard would take down Clock Tower, Air Expo. Maybe it would go to the Lava Launcher. No, it'd go to the Double Cannon. Is that what I need? No, it really isn't. Two cannon cards here could take down the Roaster, Air Expo, Lava Launcher, Double Cannon, Mega Tesla, Air. That's a lot of value. But can I get that? That's the big question. Can I get that? I gotta take down the Lava Launcher somehow, which I don't really know how I'm gonna do. So, is it worth the risk here? I mean, views or trophies, I don't know which one to pick. Why don't we bring 3? That, and then 2 Electrofire Wizards, and then we'll see if we can do something cool here. So, the plan here is somewhat simple. I'm lied. It's actually really complicated. We gotta somehow take down the Lava Launcher with the cannon cards, which means we have to take down the Roaster, the Clock Tower, and the... I think that's really about it. So we gotta take all that down. And then, and only then, can we even go for the Lava Launcher. So we gotta tank for the Lava Launcher with this Barbarian. So let's go see. They're going towards the Clock Tower, which isn't really what I wanted to see. So that's going to give a lot of damage there to my man. So why don't we go see if we can now distract Lava Launcher with this Barbarian instead. And then he's going, this isn't really what you want to see. So why don't we go ahead. We should be able to move the cannon cards out of range of the Lava Launcher like that. And then they should go onto it now. Beautiful. And then we do still have the Electrofire Wizards. And then we can't really move anything though. I don't know why. That's in range of the Archer Tower. Okay, not ideal. Not good. We could maybe... I mean, I don't really want to full send it here, but I don't really have a great option. Because we're going to... What do I do here? We need the Electrofire Wizards to do something really cool if we want to have a chance. So why don't we go move these now further forward. And I sacrifice a cannon cart. Beautiful. Love it. Great first start. And then we really gotta finish this base off somehow, but I don't really know how. Why don't we go double Electrofire Wizard now? They're being tanked for by the Battle Machine, but he's gonna get railed here. So, you know, I don't think it's over yet. It's gonna be very difficult to pull this off still. I mean, we made so many mistakes here. I don't really know how this will be possible. So let's go put those in that mode. We'll do 2 Barbarians here, and then Inferno Wizards just gotta kind of clutch up somehow. I don't think it's possible. Is it? No cannon cart. Okay, wait. Trust. Yes, we did it. Yes. Oh wow. Okay, we have 1 cannon cart now and 2 Electrofire Wizards, but for content I really need to use 4 Electrofire Wizards. So how do I do this? Maybe we don't need to keep them all alive, I guess. So we go with this, and then we could send them onto the builder hall or auto outpost. We got to take, what do we, Battlecopter onto this firecracker. We send it in with a Electrofire Wizard. That will take out the firecracker. Battlecopter should be able to clutch up everything else. And then cannon cart goes on over here, takes out the cannon, and then what? Then he could maybe, we need to get down the cannon and the double cannon. There's 4, 3 corner building. Okay. Whatever, we're gonna see where this goes here. If we hit a push trap immediately, I'm probably gonna cry, but okay, so far so good. We do have so many Electrofire Wizards. So let's just start in the first one there, and then Battlecopter from right there. We immediately get targeted onto by the guard post units, which really kinda sucks. Okay, here comes the second guard post unit. So that Electrofire Wizard was just wasted pretty much, but maybe we can get 1 chain here onto the firecracker. That would be worth it to me. Then we use Inferno ability. You know what? Maybe it wasn't a waste. We do at least get that down. So once we get down the multi-mortar, we should be able to get down the cannon too. And then we do still have so much alive. It's just how am I going to get... Okay, Battlecopter ability right there. I think he's out of range of... Oh! We might be doing something cool here, actually. Okay, let's just... Let's not freak out. Let's just try and take a breath here. We can just put all the Electrofire Wizards in a circle around the base here. And then our main goal here is to try and take out this double cannon somehow, which we actually... Is that in range? No. Wait. Ah, we do it. I was not really expecting that. I mean, Not to say I doubted myself, but then we got a 6-star with this army. What? Okay, I tried another cool attack. It didn't work well, but we're up against Rarf Gaming here, and then I don't know what to use. Oh, actually, yes, I do. I mean, what is this guy thinking? We're going to use LT Null strategy again. I mean, we aren't doing so super cool strategies, I guess, but, you know, we did still get that super clutch one with the Electrifier Wizards, and I'm happy with that one, honestly. That is probably one of the coolest attacks I've done, especially considering so much went bad and it still somehow worked out. I mean, that was cool. So why don't we go ahead? Here's the plan. We're going to use the cannon carts. They're going to go straight towards this Archer Tower like that. They get hit once by the Tesla, but that's okay. And then now we take down the Archer Tower, and we should be able to take down everything. A star Battlecopter from the corner. And then we're going to be able to take down this Archer Tower, then this Mega Tesla, then that lowered Archer Tower. And then we have everything still alive. So, I mean, this should be a pretty clutch strategy, I think, right? I mean, as long as we don't mess up, that's the big issue. And, you know, sometimes I mess up, such as my two last attacks, actually. You aren't going to see the other one, but trust me, it wasn't very good. I think it didn't even get 1 star. I mean, hogs, you don't really get a lot of stars with hogs. So I'm going to go ahead, let Battlecopter just run in there. I'll let him die. I mean, who cares? He'll be fine. I mean, he'll regenerate. You know, he's okay. He's living a good life. And then he may not even die, actually. I think he might survive this. So, yeah, he does survive. So, now we just got to finish up. There's a control Tesla. I can't really waste an ability or a baby dragon on that. And I don't think I even need to. I don't even think I need to use the other baby dragon, honestly. Let's just use that ability there. And then we'll use this ability there. And then we do need to use the other baby dragon, which is unfortunate. And we are going to lose that other baby dragon, which is actually even more unfortunate. But, you know, that's okay. We do still have the cannon carts. We do still have a fully healthy baby dragon. I'm okay with this. You know, it'll work for me. I mean, I can't really complain here. We got some cool attacks this video. I mean, swagging 5 baby dragons. Not just keeping them alive. We didn't even use them. All with the ability in the second stage. That's cool. Electrifier Wizards, 4 of them, to clutch up after making so many mistakes. We lost how many cannon carts? 3 cannon carts to stupid mistakes. Yeah, you know, I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it. I'm okay with this video. I'm actually quite glad with this video. I haven't done a video that's actually cool, in my opinion, in a while. You know, I was doing them quite consistently, and then I just kind of took a break, which, as I mentioned, actually, I guess I didn't mention. I mentioned that in the video that I recorded that is corrupted, but I guess what I will mention now is I've had an incredibly interesting last few weeks. Last month, this whole year, actually. I mean, I've had a lot of stuff go incredibly wrong. I've been in the hospital, I've been moving states, I've been doing too much. And, you know, I'm finally back in a place where I feel like I'm gonna be able to continue on with where I was, with where I was going, with what you guys were enjoying. I'm finally back to where I'm like, you know what? My mental side of it, we're good. Environment, we're good, and I feel like I have a lot more time now, and that is due to a lot of different things. And, you know, it was a very hard journey to get to where I could get this much time, and it wasn't easy, and it wasn't fun, and it was actually quite terrifying. But, you know, we're here, and we got the time now. And I know you guys didn't like the tournament videos, and I'm sorry, but look, we're back, okay? So let's be happy, I guess. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this was a fun video for you to watch. And yeah, I mean, we're back. Use code AJ, please. It wouldn't hurt. And it's also pretty cool. Just, you know, support the small creators. Go team.